Good evening. I am Kim Jackson, principal of Grandview Hospital. At this time, I would ask that you please turn off all cellular devices. I would also ask that you refrain from using noisemakers, loud talking, and shouting during the ceremony so that others can hear their graduates' names and accomplishments during the ceremony. Please rise as the graduates enter.
Thank you.
may be seated. I would like to welcome you to the commencement ceremony for the senior class of 2023. I would especially like to welcome all the parents, grandparents, relatives, teachers, and friends of these young men and women as they celebrate this important milestone in their lives. At this time, I would like to recognize the school board members of Grandview ISD, without whose leadership and support this evening would not be possible. As I say your name, please stand. Beverly Bonds, Dr. Clint Calvin, Dr. Brad Collins, Clint Ishmael, Keith Miller, Derek Moore, and Matt Slaughter. I would also like to recognize the faculty and staff of Grandview ISD that are present here tonight. Again, without whose leadership and support, this achievement would not be possible. Faculty and staff, please rise to be recognized. At this time, Nick Gonzalez will give the invocation.
Please bow your heads with me. Dear Lord, we come before you today to express our gratitude for the blessings you've bestowed upon us. We celebrate this special day and the students who stand before us. We thank you for your grace and mercy that has been with us throughout high school. As we embark on a new journey, we pray that we don't forget the blessings that have brought us to this moment. We're grateful for this school that has provided us with a solid foundation for our future. We're also grateful for the teachers who have nurtured us and cared for us, and our families who have supported us through thick and thin. We thank you for the lifelong friendships that have been formed among our classmates. May we use our abilities to glorify you and make a positive impact on the world. We ask for your guidance as we discover our place in the beautiful world you've created. Amen.
Thank you, Nick. Please rise for the playing of our national anthem. The anthem will be played by the Grandview High School Band under the direction of Mr. Travis Olson. And Racy Romero will now tell the story of the class of 2023 through the class history.
Hello, I'm Racy Romero.
And I'm Alexis Fireball.
We will be talking about our class history, just good stories and things we find significant about our time with Grandview. Beginning some of our academic careers, we start with pre-K. Not many of us started out in pre-K, but I can confidently say we were probably already called the worst group the teachers have ever had. For some reason, every single year we've been told we're the worst, so pre-K was probably no exception. Although nobody has any recollection of what happened this year, we can still acknowledge the students who were there. Monica Arriaga, Ruby Caldwell, Laura Tate, James Choate, Lana Cooper, Jackson Cromings, Jason Davis, Zoe Gutierrez, Estella Huerta, Ruby Saldana Huerta, Emmanuel Lugo, Irene Perez, Ariana Ponce, Riley Rector, Natalie Rogers, Ryan Shaw, Anthony Smith, and Carson Stafford. Now to kindergarten, where most of our students started attending. Benji Baker, Elijah Baker, Mason Cooksey, Elizabeth Crisp, Shay East, Kaysen English, Alexis Fireball, Caitlin Lee Foyt, Eric Gonzalez, Aiden Kieber, Braden Keith, River Mangum, Shelby Martin, Trevor Martin, Kylie Medinwell, Jerry Muldoon, Xavier Navarro, Johnny Palmer, Braden Price, Eli Reed, Eli Roberts, Jackson Roden, Racy Romero, Trinity Watts, EJ Williams, and Spencer Semikolsky. This year, we all started out the same. There weren't really cliques, we just existed with one another. We were all typical little kids who had that unknown stickiness on our hands that nobody really knows where it comes from. We were oblivious to the world around us and had zero responsibilities, other than to stay in the green and not get your stick moved to yellow. But as seniors, that's not what we miss about kindergarten. We care about nap time. I'm genuinely surprised we haven't protested or at least petitioned to bring that back. Other than those glorious naps on the 2-inch thin mats, we had those lofts similar to a treehouse in the corner of the classroom. Some students would play house and others would, ironically, play school while some just sat and read for AR. These were good years, but there's one thing in particular that might unlock some of y'all's childhood memories. Santa's workshop, where they would literally just unleash us into a room full of toys to buy as gifts for our parents. But it'd take hours because we had no concept of money and would try to shoplift at the age of 6. Although kindergarten was the best by a long shot, we had to move to the first grade. Now for the students who arrived this year. Madison Chadwick, Carson Mathis, Hayden Rogers, and Parker Skinner. As we all remember, we started out first grade in the old elementary. All throughout this year, we took little field trips to the new elementary until we fully moved in. We were all so excited about the new building, it would skip all the way there. I remember the construction wasn't even done and the halls were filled with little pieces of equipment. We probably shouldn't have been there because, you know, safety hazards, but it must have been the highlight because that is the only thing any of us remember from that year. After the first grade, only one student left to return later on, Estella Huerta. The next year was our second grade year. We were joined by Callie Bennett, Braden Canada, Anthony Chastain, Aiden Correggio, Nicholas Gonzalez, Hayden Hawkins, Haley Jenkins, Sydney Mathis, and Madison Mays. This year, we finally got to be in the new school full-time. Gone were the days of what became known as our asbestos-filled old school, with its huge circles, triangles, and squares painted on the cafeteria walls. Now we were in the giant, fancy school, which we all later joked looked uncanny to a prison. However, there was just one drawback with a new, massive school filled with a bunch of tiny children. We all got lost. Teachers would have to walk us through the hallways to make it to the restroom, lunch, recess, or even guidance with Coach Yates. There we would watch Reading Rainbow and the infamous show, You Can Choose. This year was full of many memories. For example, there was a time Callie and I decided to start a small mining business in the back corner of our new playground. It consisted of mining clay, then making little clay balls to leave to dry in the sun. Then there was the time Elijah convinced Kinley to color all over their paper in Miss Rayburn's class, earning them both a glorious spot on the wall in timeout. And there was the time Kinley and Shelby were play-slapping each other. When it was Kinley's turn, Shelby leaned forward, causing Kinley's slap to land right in her face. She started crying, catching Miss Rayburn's attention. When she asked what was wrong, though, Shelby decided to choose a path of peace. She said that she accidentally hit herself, saving Kinley from an inevitable second timeout on the wall. Lastly, this was our last year with our original PE teacher, Ms. G. While these precious memories were shared by many, there were a couple people who unfortunately had left this year. This year, Trinity Watts and Jason Davis left. Now on to third grade. Following are the students who joined us. Kyra Crawford, Jason Davis returned, and Acela Huerta returned. This was the year we moved to the other side of the building and earned privileges. We got a new playground, we could finally go to the sock hop, and we could play hockey and roller skate. We joined the other side of elementary. This is the year we also ventured out on more field trips. Everyone remembers what happened this year. Splash Station. Where a certain somebody, right in Canada, split his head open and needed to get Staples to fix it. What you probably don't know is that he was playing tag in the Lazy River and Xavier Navarro allegedly shoved his head into the wall ledge. Xavier still denies it to this day. Nonetheless, Brayden signed everyone's yearbook, Staple Boy. Although some kids witnessed attempted murder, third grade was still wonderful. We remember it for moving sides of the building and getting to participate in the big kid activities. It was one of the biggest years of our little lives. Fourth grade year, we were joined by Easton Abbott, Tyler Garlett, Cooper Gray, Kirsten Moore, Jacob Parsons, Cohen Sanders, and Skylar Schmidt. This year, Trinity Watts returned. This year, as it wasn't exactly a milestone, almost no one remembers much of it. However, there are a couple memories that define this year in our hearts. For example, this was the year at the sock hop that the electricity went out, leaving a bunch of 9 and 10-year-olds wandering around in the dark. Then there was a day the teachers made a YouTube video of all of them dancing. And lastly, there was Eli Reeves and Braden Price, who were known as Miss Block's designated fanners when she had a hot flash. Now we come to the last part of this year, with the memories for which fourth grade is infamously known for. First, this year the tag game called Infection took the school by storm, gaining half the grade in a single game of insane tagging and extreme trust issues. And second, there was Kinley. She single-handedly convinced everyone she talked to that she was a secret mermaid among her human classmates. Was she lying? We will never know. No matter how much she may deny that she is a mermaid now, we all know her true mermaid nature. We're on to it, Kinley. This year also started the continuous trend of Hayden Hawkins and his lack of commitment to Grandview. This year, he left. The next year, at long last, we finally came to the big kids of the school. Our fifth grade year, while our last in elementary school, was one full of adventures. A few students joined us. Graciela Beltran, Jordan Varela, Tyler Ward, and Ryder Williams. This year, we had the privilege of going to Branson. We did great while we were there, but we were just crazy little fifth graders let loose in a whole different state. But we got to perform with wonderful people while our families proudly watched. It's something we'll forever remember, as well as something else. On the bus ride home, Gracie, my little speech partner, and I sat together. I was sleeping against the window, and she was knocked out, leaning against me. I got uncomfortable, and I sat up a little, causing Gracie to lean the other way directly into the aisle. She was quite literally hanging over the armrest into the aisle, just sleeping like that. Although Branson was an experience in and of itself, we had many little activities in school. We had the lovely Pioneer Day. You know, where we're basically statues and wait for parents or teachers to press a button and we get to explain who we are. Everyone loved it, especially the parents. They loved watching us grow throughout the year, but they were painfully aware of us moving on to middle school the year following. Fifth grade, we got to walk out at the end of the year to honor our time in elementary. Gotta say, we soaked up that attention. Thankfully we did, because year following, we weren't the stars of the show anymore. After fifth grade, only Carson Stafford left. Sixth grade year, we were joined by Kendall Baxter, Seth Green, Gavin King, Ian Kronovic, Addison Pierce, and Jay Hall. Also this year, we were graced with Hayden Hawkins' return. Our first day of middle school, we were robbed of our big kid status we had fought for many years to earn. Sixth grade year, once again, we were at the bottom of the race. But believe it or not, Mr. Jackson just couldn't bear the thought of us going through the little kid years again alone. As we moved to the junior high, he moved with us. This year, we would jump at the sound of every bell and would rush through the hallways with our new fast-paced lives. This was our first time having more than four classes, and also our first year not having the same schedules as everyone else. Everyone was stressed in the new environment, but over time, we learned to adapt. This year, a certain person, who shall remain unnamed, was surprised on their birthday by their big sister returning from her first Korean tour in the military. Sixth grade year, Elizabeth Crisp left the Zebra family. Seventh grade consisted mostly of the switch from PE to athletics. Not much happened this year, but we did gain quite a few students. Tristan Allen, Joshua Carney, Kyla Johnson, Andrea Jones, Mason Metzler, Taylor Villarias, Anaya Villarreal, Quentin Westmoreland, Will Woody, and Elizabeth Crisp returned and Carson Stafford returned. We didn't experience much this year. It was honestly pretty chill. We did sports with Grandview and we were split into A, B, and C teams. That process was either a massive ego boost or the most humiliating thing you will ever experience. Another thing that was quite interesting is about none other than Carson Stafford. We came back to school on a regular Monday, only to find that he had dyed his hair jet black. For the record, it used to be blonde. Not only that, but when he tried to go back to normal, it turned a shade of orange that can only be described as the rust you find on an old scooter. This year, two students left, Hayden Hawkins, again, and Spencer Semitolsky. Eighth grade year, once again, we were at the top. This year, joining us as the big kids was Jonathan Metters, Wade Plummer, and Jacob Burner. After being in junior high for so long, we hardly even noticed the bells anymore. The common phrase, "Did the bell just ring?" became an everyday matter from then on. This year was full of memories. For the girls in athletics, this was the year we were helping prepare for a track meet, and Zoe yelled to grab everyone's attention, only to say, "Look at the sun!" in a very tiny voice, with her arms gestured like Barbie arms to a foggy sunrise. For the people in James's math class with Miss Teakill, this was the year she broke into a dead sprint to run at him from across the classroom. For the whole grade, this was the year our librarian and all the teachers gathered us in the library, once again told us we were the worst grade they ever had, then proceeded to show an entire slideshow presentation on how unorganized our lockers were. To anyone here that may be in the grades below us, this is exactly why there are now shelves everywhere in the junior high for bags. You're welcome. And finally, for all that remember, this was the year our Zebras became the state champions in football. At the end of the year, our librarian stated she almost quit because of us, that we once again had a clap out as we left the school to return to the bottom of the ranks at our next school. This is where we start high school. We were joined by a few students this year. Blake Allen, Olivia Bowerslog, Lainey Bell, and Kyla Perry. We were all nervous but so excited. Freshman year was hard because of the new environment and constantly being called a fishy. I'm kidding. Freshman year wasn't hard. Spanish 1 was. Nothing against you though, Miss McCormick. You were a great teacher, we were just awful. I don't want to trigger any trauma from that classroom though, so moving on. This year, hold on. Sorry, I thought I reread by accident. Mr. Jackson moved with us again. He's just a little bit obsessed with us. Kidding, maybe. Not only did we have the privilege of seeing Jackson's face every day for another 4 years, but this year our football team won the state championship once again. It was an amazing time for our class, but there is something we need to apologize for. We were a rough freshman class. One teacher who is fully aware of that is Coach Villard. One day, his second period class had a sub and they were taking a test. Braden Canada spoke up and said, "Isn't this test open note?" Everyone in the class agreed, even though it in fact was not open note. 5 minutes after starting the test, Lillard came in and scolded the class until he asked who started it. Everyone collectively, without hesitation, blamed our valedictorian, Olivia Bowerslog. Fast forward some time and we began to approach spring break. There were talks of COVID, about a literal plague and a worldwide pandemic, but we were oblivious to what was to come. We all sat in our seventh period when the announcements kicked on. We got an extra spring break week for safety reasons. We were ecstatic, because who doesn't love an extra spring break week? Those 2 weeks went on and turned into 9. That excitement went away. We transitioned to online school, and it was a big change for all of us. We lost a lot of people, but we made it through. The awful thing is that we were literally joking about a plague weeks prior and how bad 2020 was so far. We jinxed ourselves so hard. Only one student left, and again, it's a solo work. Now, our first year back from COVID was a hectic one, to say the least. Sophomore year, we were joined by Caden Blackman, AJ Clarkson, Brandon Cliff, and Kaylee Holden. Additionally, this year, Spencer Samatolsky and the infamous Hayden Hawkins returned and were finally here to stay. Returning from COVID, our classes had a mixture of online and in-person people. Students who were online for a year, like our very own salutatorian, were only recognizable by name and whatever profile picture they had. All of the in-person people were required to wear masks, so they were only recognizable by their eyes and muffled voices. Throughout the whole year, as people began to become sick, they would switch to online classes for a minimum of 2 weeks. For example, in December, after a single positive test, the entire Lady Zebras basketball program was out for the count until the next semester. This year, in Ms. Davenport's Human Growth and Development class, one student asked Natalie Rogers to pass her a binder. Natalie decided to do the only sensible thing and threw it. In a beautiful arc, the binder flew through the air and hit that student in the back of the head. Thankfully, though, she turned out fine, but Natalie has since learned the dangers of fast-moving binders. At the end of the year, the mask mandate was finally lifted. Everyone was shocked to see each other's faces, and we all had to relearn proper facial expressions and conversations, as they were no longer hidden. If somebody said something stupid, you couldn't hide your reaction. This year, because they didn't love us enough, Taylor Valerius and Hayden Rogers left. Then we have junior year, the one we so lovingly call the year you either drown or swim. Only three people joined us this year: Aubrey Egan, Miriam Fryer, and Jesse Hernandez. Nobody likes junior year, except for the band kids, because we went to state and we're in the top five. We don't talk about finals, those didn't happen. But junior year was particularly bad for somebody that broke their jaw. I'm not sure who, me. I may or may not have lost a sword fight. It was also hard for our salutatorian, Elijah Baker. After attending online school his whole sophomore year, he returned junior year. He literally got COVID 3 separate times after coming back. He still, to this day, can't smell anything. But really, this year was hard for everybody. Classes were the most difficult, and we were that much closer to college decisions. We all struggled, but pushed through, and somehow kept our heads above water. Thankfully, we did have some sort of comedic relief. River Mangum is to thank for some of that. In art class, she was trying to open glue when the lid somehow popped off, resulting in a beautiful fountain of glue. It managed to get everywhere, even on the ceiling. Aiden Kieber didn't even notice the glue dripping onto him from the ceiling, so he just sat there until somebody else noticed, and he had to go home to get it off. This year, we also had one class of Spanish 3. Kinley, Kaysen, Nick, Haley, and Cooper had to make a skit for a project. Halfway through them doing the skit, they acted like they were thrown into a river, but they only had one small toddler life-sized jacket. Cooper was the one to try and put this life jacket on. If you don't know, Cooper's about 6'2". He's a big guy. He jumps to shore to get out of the river, which is obviously the equivalent of diving into a classroom table. In the process, his arms got stuck in the life jacket, so he couldn't get up and ended up busting his chin open on the table. He was like one massive turtle stuck, flipped over, desperately trying to get up. They somehow managed to score a 99 on that project. And to make matters even better, Kaysen threw a stick and hit Kinley in the head with it. Junior year was hard, but the fun times and good people made it that much better. And finally, we are brought to our senior year. This year, we were joined by Isaiah Bootsky, and we were rejoined by Hayden Rogers, Taylor Valerius, and finally, Estella Gordon. Once again, guys, we made it. We were now the big kids of our school. This year, the stereotypical high school cliques dissolved, and we all became friends just for the sake of being friends. This year contained many memories, most of which we will never forget and will forever hold dear in our hearts. One memory, for example, for the few of us who barely survived calculus, was of our glorious failure. Miss Tiller walked in the next day after a test and asked if we wanted the good news or the bad news first. We chose bad news first, and she told us that everyone failed. Yippee. Then she decided to reveal the good news. We all took the wrong test that was very hard. Yippee. For our calculus class, and Miss Tiller, that one's for you. This year, knowing there was an end very near, our grade all grew closer as a class. We all laughed and cried together as we struggled to survive this year. Now, whether the cry was from sadness, from leaving everything we've ever known behind, or from being overwhelmed by schoolwork, we will never know. But one thing is for certain, this was a year of blood, sweat, and many, many tears. For athletes, we worked hard to prove ourselves worth something in our last year of our sport. For the people who worked themselves to near death academically, we worked hard to learn and prove our achievement in class. For the students who had jobs after school, we worked long hours to make money for ourselves or for our families, and still showed up for school the next day. And for the people who just wanted to have fun, we worked hard to make the most of our last year together. And to that, I say, we all succeeded.
Well, that's all. Our years together have come to an end. We now go our separate ways and start new journeys. We wish you the best of luck. Thank you for being here. Congratulations, class of 2023.
Thank you, Alexis and Racy. The salutatorian for this year's class is Elijah Baker. At this time, Elijah will come forward to give his address.
Greetings, family, friends, teachers, all of the GVISD staff and alumni. My name is Elijah Baker, and I've been given the extraordinary opportunity to cordially speak to you on behalf of the class of 2023. When I contemplatively look back on these last 4 years of high school that we all spent together, I think they can only be accurately described with a well-known quote by the late Dr. Charles Dickens. This quote is as it follows. It was the best of times, it was the worst of times. It was the age of wisdom, it was the age of foolishness. It was the approach of belief, it was the approach of incredulity or doubt. We had everything before us, yet we felt that we had nothing before us. I truly believed that this quote ultimately describes all the hopes, fears, dreams, and occasional heartache we felt at some point or another throughout our high school years. However, please do not misunderstand that. I am not here to focus on the shortcomings of our class. Far from that. I am here to shed light on the fact that each of the seniors here before you today had an individual part in making GVISD what it is today, with the help of a loving fellow. I am very proud to call myself a part of the class of 2023. This is for many reasons, but one that stands out to me the most is our bond and perseverance. Our class has gone through many ups and downs, including COVID. But yet, we did not let that fall to us. We pushed through and made it here today. The memories that we have all made at GHS are priceless, and the friendships that we have made over the years are bonds that will last forever. This place has been a second home to most of us. It's a bittersweet moment to say goodbye to one last time, but also the start of a new chapter of our lives. Many of you who know me know that I tend to stress about every little detail when it comes to my school. In some ways, that has helped me get to where I am today, but in others, it has hurt me. I have recently come to the conclusion that stress is not the answer. As we embark on our paths, we will all come across times where we will have to face stress. That is just the real world. But it is important to realize that you just have to let that stuff go. Life is too short to spend it worrying and stressed about every little thing. So let it go. At the end of the day, our Father in Heaven has a plan for us all. So it is important to trust him and let him. I encourage you, the class of 2023, to not only follow the opportunities available to you, but to follow your heart and pursue a cause of particular importance to you. I challenge you all to make your own path. The risks will always be present, but you will learn from all the mistakes you make and will be able to stand up through that experience. It may be the best of times or the worst of times, but remember, all things come to an end. You will see another day. Again, I would like to thank all the GVISD staff, family, and friends who have given us tremendous support throughout our years here at GHS. I would also especially like to thank our principal, Mr. Jackson, for leading us through our senior year. I cannot say enough how appreciative we are that you were able to share our journey with us, and I hope that GBISD thrives in the years to come. Like many times before, I'm proud to say it once more. It's a great day to be a Zebra. Thank you.
Thank you, Elijah. Scholarships for the class of 2023 were released in a video yesterday, but I do want to mention the class of 2023 was awarded in excess of $1 million in scholarships. Congratulations, class of 2023. Ryder Williams, please come to the stage. Ryder has answered the call to serve and enlist in the United States Navy. He is being recognized tonight for his commitment to honor and serve by receiving a certificate of special recognition sent from U.S. Congressman Jake Elvin. Ryder, thank you for your service to our country. Having the honor of delivering the valedictorian address this year will be Olivia Bowerslaw.
Good evening. I am honored to have this opportunity as the class of 2023's valedictorian to share a few words with you tonight. First, on behalf of myself and my classmates, I would like to thank all of our friends and family that join us here this evening. I would also like to thank the teachers, coaches, school board members, and administrators that have helped us pursue excellence in our academic and extracurricular activities. On a personal note, to my parents, your love, support, and guidance have been the foundation of my life and have helped me become the person I am today. I appreciate all the sacrifices you have made for me over the years, and I cannot thank you enough. And finally, to my brother Seth, who is the salutatorian of class of 2019, I want to remind him of the immortal words of Ricky Bobby and Talladega Knight when he said, "If you're not first, you're last." I want to thank you for being the big brother that sets the bar high in terms of achievement, both in the classroom and athletically. I was able to look up to you and be inspired by your dedication, hard work, and achievements. My personal journey to tonight also taught me perseverance. Most of you probably don't know, but I was denied admission to Grandview ISD as a transfer student twice during my junior high years. Before Mr. Basham made his decision to allow me to follow in my brother's footsteps as a Grandview Zebra. That process taught me never to take for granted being able to be in a place like Grandview. And as Mr. Basham always loves to say, it's a great day to be a Zebra. After many days contemplating what message I would deliver tonight, I finally sat down to write my speech with the intent to identify what it is that enabled me to be your valedictorian, and what characteristics are so culturally ingrained in our school community that it allows Grandview to excel in so many areas. I stumbled across a quote by the American author Jim Rohn that encapsulates the message I want to convey tonight. He reminds us that discipline is the bridge between goals and accomplishments. Every person in this stadium right now at one point in their life has set a goal for themselves that is achievable. However, the reality of the world is that we all struggle at times with self-discipline needed to build the bridge to accomplishment. For me, I set the goal of being ranked number one the day Seth was ranked number two. There are plenty of classmates who are smart or smarter than me, but my discipline and hard work enabled me to achieve my goal. However, while this one example centers around academics, what makes Grandview special is the self-discipline that is exhibited in a multitude of ways. Football players getting up every Saturday morning after games to watch film to better themselves. One-act play members staying up late at night for countless hours perfecting their show. The Thundering Herd Band getting up every morning before the crack of dawn to fine-tune their performance. UIL academic and debate teams working on their craft to win yet another district championship. The volleyball team beating teams that had never been beaten in school history. And the softball team being relentless through every practice and game in hopes to obtain a state title. Grandview ISD is full of individuals that exhibit self-discipline, and that is what sets us apart from other schools. The culture at Grandview High School is centered around striving to be the best. We work tirelessly to put in long hours to achieve our goals while supporting and encouraging each other along the way. This drive, focus, and desire for excellence is what fuels our success and gives us a deep pride in being a part of the Grandview Zebra family. We are forever connected to one another, to those who came before us, and to those who will follow after. This culture is not limited to the hallways of Grandview High School. The streets are often lined with zebra flags in front of homes and businesses, and we see the faces of the Grandview community at our events proudly cheering us on. The foundation of our zebra spirit is built upon the support of our community, which includes former students, families, and many others who love and support zebras as their own. Their passion and support for the students at Grandview ISD are our source of power and strength for our zebra pride. To my fellow classmates, as we move on to this next chapter of life, we will carry with us the ideals of what it means to be a zebra. We are the future. We have the power to change the world, to make a difference, and to leave our mark. So let us go out there and do just that. Let us be the best version of ourselves. Let us be kind, let us be brave, and let us make a positive impact wherever we go. Congratulations, class of 2023, on this incredible journey we embarked on, and the future goals you will one day accomplish. I can't wait to see what the future holds for each and every one of us. Before I leave the stage tonight, I would like to ask that y'all come out and support your Lady Zebra softball team on Saturday at 7 o'clock at Lake Belton High School as we battle the Lady Lions for a spot at stake. Thank you.
Thank you, Olivia. Mr. Basham, Board of Trustees, I present to you the class of 2023 as candidates for graduation. They have fulfilled all the academic requirements set forth by the Texas Education Agency and the Grandview Independent School District and are therefore eligible for graduation. Will the first row please rise? Easton James Abbott. Blake Wilson Allen. Tristan Tyler Allen. Monica Nevea Arriaga. Benjamin Harrison Baker. Olivia Rose Bauerschlager. Elijah Allen Baker. Kendall Alexis Baxter. Lainey Michelle Bell. Graciela Renee Beltran. Callie Elizabeth Bennett. Caden Michael Blackman. Isaiah Braden Bootski. Ruby Grace Caldwell. Braden Glenn Canada. Joshua Allen Corning. Madison Elizabeth Chadwick. Anthony Ryan Chastain. James Edwin Choate. Aiden James Clarkston. Brandon Todd Click. Mason John Cooksey. Lana Ashton Cooper. Aiden Patrick Carrigio. Tyron Danelle Crawford. Elizabeth Ann Crisp. Jackson Lee Romine. Jacelyn Priyata Davis.
Go, Piglet!
Aubrey Anna Aiken. Shade Josephine East. Jason Thomas English. Alexis Dawn Hope Fireball. Kinley Rose Boyd. Miriam Anayanse Friday Martinez. Tyler James Garlett.
Nicholas Dooley Gonzalez. Eric Gonzalez Beltran. Laura Caitlin Graham Newton. Cooper Rex Gray. Flint Bryson Green. Zoe Lauren Gutierrez. Hayden Jack Hawkins. Jesse Lee Hernandez. Kaylee Michelle Hobeck. Stella Herta. Yeah! Haley Ann Jenkins. Kyla Ann Johnson. Andrea Christy Jones. Aiden Blaze Kiever. Robert Braden Keith. Gavin Richard King. Ian Patrick Kronovich. Emmanuel Lugo. River Leanne Mangum. Shelby Grace Martin. Trevor Scott Martin. Carson Timothy Mathis.
Don't trip.
Sydney Renee Mathis. Taylor May. Jonathan Allen Metters. Kylie Victoria Maidenwalk. Mason Keith Metzler. Kirsten Shane Moore. Jerry Patrick Muldoon. Xavier Anthony Navarro. Yanni Michaela Palmer. Jacob Wesley Parsons. Addison Christine Pierce. Guadalupe Irene Perez. Kyla Faith Perry. Wade Emerson Plummer. Ariana Elise Hunt. Braden Luke Price. Riley Renee Rector. Eli Mac Green. Jacob Carl Rome. Elijah Lawson Roberts. Jackson Bryce Roden. Hayden Michael Rogers. Natalie Jean Rogers. Gracie Diane Romero. Ruby Esmeralda Saldana Herta. Cohen Steve Sanders. Skylar Renee Schmidt. Ryan Christopher Shaw. Woo! Parker Neil Skinner. Anthony Raylin Smith. Carson Dakota Stafford. Spencer David Samotowski. Taylor Shea Valerius. Jordan Isidro Varela. Jacob Garrett Vernon. Anaya Marie Villarreal. Braden Kyler Ward. Trinity Rose Ross. Quentin Charles Westmoreland. Dean Ryder Williams. Elizabeth Jane Williams. William Thomas Woody III. Tammy Hudson, Senior Class Advisor, will lead the graduates in the changing of the tassel.
As you look back on your high school years, there are many memories and experiences that you remember with fondness. The things that you have accomplished during your high school years have brought you to this time in your life. After today, you will start a new experience. The tassel ceremony is an outward expression of all that you have learned in high school. By moving the tassel from the right side of your hat to the left side, you are showing the rest of the world that you have completed all the required courses from Grandview High School for graduation. Seniors, move your tassels from the right to the left. Exceeded all of our expectations. Congrats.
Graduates, standing before you tonight, I am proud to say I've been here with you through it all. We all look forward in seeing the success you achieve in the next chapters of your life. But be reassured, I am not following you this time. However, I will be here if you ever need me. You have continued to reach the high expectations set before you and have left them for the Zebras younger than you to follow. For this class of 2023, we thank you and best wishes. Our ceremony will conclude this evening with a benediction given by Scholar Schmidt. Graduates, please stand. Thank you. ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2023.